Morning, guys. Good morning to you. It is Friday, the 22nd of January. We are racing through the weeks in January. Today I am in the maths intervention room. It's the little room in the corner of the hall, if you're not sure. And I found a little cube, and I think I was going to show you a little trick on it. Okay, so here we go. We need to see if we can make this disappear, okay? We're going to see if we can get it across the room, okay? I'm going to put it over there somewhere. Ready? Got to tap it three times. Gone. Okay, we'll see if we can find it later on, all right? Please remind me to share with you if I've managed to make it go across. So over, hopefully it's over there. Right, let's share my screen. Guided reading with you. So on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we do English. And then on a Friday, we have our guided reading lesson. Obviously, our class text this term is Babe, the sheep pig. So it is based around that. So can you pause the video and get today's date and waltz in your book? So Friday, the 22nd of January. And our waltz today is to discuss some words and phrases that capture the reader's interests and imagination. Okay, so basically that means that we're going to be looking at why do we pick up a book? Okay, what books interest us and what makes us want to read them? Okay, so that's what we're going to be looking at today. All right, once you have done your date and waltz, you can answer these two questions below. You might want to pause it if you're in class, or if you're at home, you might want to talk about it. If you've got no one with you at home and you're doing this all by yourself, well done. Maybe you can just have a think about these questions in your head. Okay, so pause the video now. Alrighty, so let's just have a quick think. Let's put our pencils down or pens down and stop. The sheep pig. Miss Ryan has been expertly reading them, the chapters so far in the sheep pig story. And what I'd like you to do, if you're in class, you can chat with the person next to you or have a class discussion about what has happened so far. If you're at home, do the same, please. Have a think. Characters, which characters have we met so far? Mr. and Mrs. Hoggett, or Farmer Hoggett and his wife. There's lots of characters that we've met so far. Okay, so see if you can think of those. And also, more importantly, what has been your favourite part so far? I think my favourite part so far is during the first chapter, actually, when Farmer Hoggett wins the sheep pig, or Babe the pig. Remember, he went to the fair that was happening in the village, and he guessed the weight of the pig, and he got it right, which meant that he got to keep it. I think that really sets the story off nicely, because it was just by chance, it was pure luck that Babe the pig and Farmer Hoggett met. And they go on to have an amazing adventure, which I'm not going to ruin for you, because I don't think you've finished it yet. Some of you might have the book at home and have read it before, but I'm not going to ruin it for those of you who haven't. So yeah, definitely, that's my favourite part. So pause the video if you'd like to talk about it now. Alrighty, so going back to our waltz, our interest. So within the waltz, it says something about the interest, what captures our imagination. So I want you to have a pause again and have a quick chat, 30 seconds. What interests you? I've put some inspiration on the slide here. So have a quick chat about that. What makes you do the things you do? All right, great. So what interests us? The reason we do things is because we like them. All right, so that is exactly the same with a book. Interest is the same when we're talking about books. What captures our imagination? So I personally, you might not have the same opinion, but I personally really love the sheep pig. The reason I love the sheep pig is because I grew up on a farm, and it reminds me, and I've got lots of memories in my head about what it was like to live on a farm. So the sheep pig gives me lots of memories like that. I love animals, and the thought of a pig behaving like a sheepdog is really funny. So that makes me not want to put this book down. So think about what your interests are, and think about what sort of books that you like reading or would read more of if you had the choice. Okay, so you can pause the video now and have a quick chat about that. Okay, it's a shame that we're not all in one room being able to talk about our own opinions, and this is what it's all about. This is actually a really good oracy activity, because it means that we're all always talking, and I want you to share this as much as possible. Even if you're at home by yourself, you can always talk out loud by yourself. That's absolutely fine. We won't think you're going crazy. So if you want to do that, that's absolutely fine. Okay, so let's look at this book here, The Sheep Pig. Often the case, we have a book, we go to a library or we go to the book corner, and the first thing that will capture our imagination or catch our eye is the front cover. So is this, in your opinion, now remember, these are all opinions. The person next to you or someone else in your house might not have the same opinion as you. You might like it, you might not like it, okay? So is this front cover interesting, do you think? Does it capture your imagination? Why or why not? All right, so I'm going to give you my opinion because I'm here. I actually think this front cover doesn't really capture my imagination. I like pigs, but it doesn't really tell me anything about the story. I like that that bit at the bottom about the author, Dick Kingsford, the master of animal adventures. That makes me kind of want to read on a little bit more, but a picture of a pig on the front cover doesn't really help me that much. So I need a bit more information. Where could I go to find a bit more information? Pause the video and have a think. Okay, hopefully some of you have said the blurb. Okay, what is the blurb? Pause the video and have a chat. If you're not sure, where would I find this bit of information? Okay, hopefully you've said that you would find the blurb on the back of the book, okay? So if I wasn't that sure about a book, because this front cover doesn't really inspire me at the moment, I want to find out a little bit more. So I'm gonna flip it over onto the back and I'm gonna have a look. Why can't I learn to be a sheep pig? Orphan piglet Babe thinks his luck might be changing when he's won at a fair by Farmer Hoggett. Back on the farm, Fly, the kind-hearted sheepdog, adopts him. Babe wants to do everything Fly can do. He knows he can't be a sheepdog, but could he be the world's very first sheep pig? Now, that definitely, all of a sudden, as I said earlier, I think that really does capture my imagination. A sheep pig, what even is that? Okay, so I think I'd want to read on a bit more about that. Okay, so what we're going to do today, we're going to have a look at some of the book. I've got some go deep and go deeper questions for you, and I would like to see how you get on with it. So another quick discussion point, what parts of the book have interested you most? Think about it. What has it been describing? What has it been about? So maybe you could have a quick summary. Think back to Miss Ryan's videos. What has she told us about so far? Okay, what other animals were on the farm when Babe comes back from the fair? And where do we go from there? Okay, I think she's up to about chapter 7 at the moment. So there's lots of information so far that we've been told. Okay, so here are some of the questions that you're going to be answering in your books, okay? It says, please answer these questions in your book. What interested you about the book when you first picked it up? All right, now lots of you obviously haven't been in class, all right? When Miss Ryan told you that we're gonna be reading The Sheep Pig, okay? What did you first think, okay? So what did you first think it might be about? Can you make sure when you're answering it in your book that you're writing in full sentences? So what interested you most about the book when you first picked it up? Okay, you need to write, when I first looked at or heard that we were reading The Sheep Pig, I thought, and then you can tell me your opinion, okay? Did anything grab your imagination on the front or the back cover? Now, I have, obviously you can flick back to here, so did anything capture your imagination? Okay, if not, if it's, no, nothing, give me a reason why, okay? Please tell me why you didn't get any, you know, why were you not that interested in this book? What I'd like you to do then is underline the words. So you're not going to underline the words that interest you. What I'd like you to do is look back at the blurb. Okay, question three this is. And look carefully at any of the words there that make you think, ooh, either I don't know what that means, or ooh, that makes me really interested. If I were to answer this question, I think I would... I would choose something like the very first, or a phrase, the very first sheep pig, because there's no such thing as a sheep pig. So that sort of makes me interested. I want to find out what is a sheep pig. Okay, so that is question three. Now, your go deeper activity is actually a drawing activity. Okay, and it says, please read the description from the opening few chapters of The Sheep Pig. Now, I've been really kind. I have copied and pasted. This is chapter one, all right? And it tells us all about when Farmer Hoggett first met Babe. If you would prefer not to read it, okay, it'd be great if you can, okay? It's good practice. However, if you scroll back on Class Dojo to Thursday, the 7th of January, it was the second day of home learning, Miss Ryan has filmed herself, and you can go back and read and listen again to chapter one. Okay, so you can hear what you know, what she's describing. All right, so that's chapter one. And then on page two, okay, I've got part of chapter two. And again, if you want to listen to it rather than reading all the way through it, you can go back to Monday, the 11th of January on the class story, and Miss Ryan is reading it on there. Okay, so I would read the first two chapters. Okay, that's what you need to do first for the Go Deeper. What it says, can you draw a detailed sketch of the place described in the writing? So again, it's your opinion based on what you've read. You need to draw me a picture of maybe Farmer Hoggett's farm, because there's loads of description in that story about what it's like there. I know that he describes there being a pond, okay, several barns and the farmhouse. And they tell us lots of information about the fields that are near the farm. So what I'd like you to do is perhaps have a go, once you've done the go deep, once you've answered the first three questions, at the go deeper, which is labeling a sketch, a drawing, that it matches it matches the description within the book. Okay, so you can perhaps draw some of the farm animals that they talk about in that description as well. Okay, so that is your job for today. Okay, answer the first three questions. I'm just flicking back through. Okay, yeah, answer the first three questions in the Go Deep. All right, and then have a go underneath at the Go Deeper. All right, if you have any questions, please message. Okay, if you need to pause the film at any point, here is chapter one, so you can pause and begin reading that. I think that would be a really good start. Okay, so you pause that and read chapter one. Once you have read chapter one, you can pause and begin to read chapter two. Remember, the options are there for you to listen to them as well. Please shout if you need any help. Stop sharing that. Lots of you are probably thinking, all right, Mr. Bamwell, where's that cube gone? Okay, I think I put it over here. Oh no, Al. It was always managed to make it disappear in the wrong direction. There it is. Have a great day.